mission of the American Association of Heart Failure Nurses is to lead nurses that are caring for heart failure patients. Patient education is at the center of that mission. Heart failure patients go through a variety of phases managing their chronic disease, from newly diagnosed to end-of-life care. And the vision of this organization is to assist you no matter where you are on the continuum. We care about your health and want to give you the tools that you need to actively participate in your own care. What is heart failure? We will start with a quick overview of the heart. The heart is a four-chambered organ that pumps oxygen-rich blood to the body. The right side of the heart receives oxygen-poor blood from the body and pumps the blood to the lungs to become oxygenated. The left side of the heart receives oxygen-rich blood from the lungs and pumps the blood to the body. Heart failure is a condition with many different causes, including heart attack, high blood pressure, and valve problems. Whatever the cause, the heart, or more specifically, the left ventricle, cannot pump enough blood to the body to meet the body's needs. There are two different types of heart failure. In systolic heart failure, the left ventricle does not squeeze well enough to push blood out to the body to meet the body's needs. In diastolic heart failure, the left ventricle has become stiff and does not open well enough to fill properly, which leads to less blood being pumped to the body. The symptoms of heart failure are caused by the decrease in blood flow to the body. A person with heart failure may notice that he gets winded with activities like walking stairs or an incline, doing housework or yard work. Sometimes the shortness of breath occurs when the person with heart failure tries to lay down to sleep. Another symptom is fatigue or tiredness with even light activity. A person with heart failure may notice swelling in his legs, feet, or belly. Self-care. Heart failure is a chronic illness that can be managed with close self-care. Knowledge is power. Learn as much as you can about heart failure and talk with your healthcare team about your heart failure. Making healthy lifestyle behavior changes and building new skills will help you meet your goals. As you learn new self-care behaviors, you will better manage your heart failure symptoms. Take all medications prescribed to you. Talk to your healthcare team about any over-the-counter or herbal medicines. Talk to your healthcare team if you're not able to buy your medicines. Enjoy low-sodium meals. Be sure to plan out your meals and read food labels. Avoid salt by using spices to season your food. Weigh yourself daily and track your weight. By watching your weight closely, you will catch any rapid weight gain, which could be extra fluid building up in your body. Stay as active as you can. Talk to your healthcare team before starting any exercise. They will involve you in making a plan. Know how heart failure affects you and make changes in your daily routine to conserve energy. Know the common symptoms of heart failure. Self-care management means you will decide to recognize change in symptoms, report any change to your healthcare team, follow treatment advice, and evaluate your response. Diagnosing and treatment of heart failure. There are many different tests that can diagnose heart failure. The most common test is the echocardiogram. This is an ultrasound of the heart. Often additional tests are required. The treatment of heart failure starts with treating underlying conditions that are causing heart failure. There are many conditions that can cause heart failure, including blocked heart arteries, heart valves that do not work properly, high blood pressure, and abnormal heart rhythms. Medications are important in the treatment of heart failure. The classes of medications listed on this slide all work together to treat symptoms of heart failure and slow the progression of heart failure. It is very important that you take your medications as directed by your healthcare provider. If you have questions about your medications or are worried about side effects, you should discuss your concerns with your nurse or doctor. There are some medications that can make heart failure worse. You should always check with your nurse or doctor before starting any new medications, including pain relievers, vitamins, and supplements. It is important to take your medications every day and at the same time every day. Keeping your medicines organized in a pill box will help you remember to take them and will help you keep track of when you need to order a new supply. You should never run out of your heart failure medicines. If your heart failure does not improve with medications alone, your doctor or nurse may recommend additional therapies for you, including an implanted defibrillator or pacemaker. If your heart failure continues to worsen, you may be referred for a heart pump or heart transplant. You are the most important person in the treatment of your heart failure. It is important to talk with your healthcare providers and family on a regular basis about your personal goals of care and milestones that you would like to accomplish. Activity and heart failure. Research continues to support that increased activity can be a valuable tool in helping people with heart failure to feel better. Staying active and doing regular exercise may increase your ability to do more of the things you enjoy. Before you begin an exercise program, it's a good idea to discuss your exercise plans with your doctor. Your doctor may recommend a program called cardiac rehabilitation, which is a program that includes monitoring of your heart's function as you follow an exercise plan designed just for you. For most people, setting a goal of 20 to 30 minutes of activity on most days is a reasonable goal. You should start slowly with only short amounts of exercise, then gradually increase the amount of time you spend exercising. Don't overlook the value of even very short periods of exercise. Increased activity for as little as 5 or 10 minutes can have a positive effect. Stick to simple, easy-to-do activities, like walking or biking. Walking can be done both indoors and out, in good weather and bad. Start with a short distance and gradually increasing the time or distance you walk. Strength training is another great idea. Stretching exercises, using large elastic bands, or using light hand weights are simple ways to start building the strength in your arms. A pool is a great place to exercise, especially if you have pain in your joints. Here are some tips to make your exercise program a success. Start slowly after you have spoken to your doctor. Wait at least an hour after eating before you exercise. Plan to do your exercise during the time of day when you have the most energy. Don't exercise if you are not feeling well or if the doctor has recently changed your medications. Know the warning signs. Shortness of breath that does not get better when you stop. Feeling faint or dizzy. Chest pain, tightness or pressure. Pain in your shoulders, arms, neck or jaw. Skipped heartbeats or really fast or slow heart rate. Feeling extremely tired. Severe sweating or nausea. If the symptoms do not get better, stop the activity. Call 911 if your symptoms do not go away. Other conditions. Atrial fibrillation can be very common in persons with heart failure. It is a condition that can cause symptoms similar to heart failure, such as shortness of breath or feeling like your heart is racing, because the top chambers of your heart are beating faster than the bottom chambers. Atrial fibrillation is treated by either taking medications to control the heart rhythm or rate, or by shocking the heart back into a regular rhythm. Either way, you will need to take blood thinners to prevent clots. If you have lost interest in things that used to give you pleasure or are feeling hopeless, please talk to a medical provider. When depression is treated, it can make other chronic conditions less difficult to manage. It can also improve your quality of life. Having low or high potassium is easily managed through dietary changes or changes to medications. Your provider will draw routine blood work to keep track of your potassium. Your provider may change your heart failure medications or diet to correct the problem. Sleep apnea is common in heart failure, and if left untreated, can make heart failure symptoms worse. Sleep apnea is treated with an apparatus that is worn at night called CPAP. If you wake up feeling unrested in the morning, Have been told that you stop breathing in your sleep, snore, or catnap during the day? Tell your medical provider. You may need an overnight sleep study. If you are feeling overwhelmed and are having difficulty managing your day-to-day life, contact your medical provider. You can learn how to manage stress. Pulmonary hypertension is a condition of high blood pressure in the arteries or veins of the lungs. It can be caused by heart failure or can occur from other causes. It is detected by an echocardiogram or right heart catheterization. It is treated by treating your heart failure or by other medications. It can be a sign of worsening heart failure. Be sure to visit our patient education website and call our Heartline for more information.